why do women stay with guys they think are pieces of shit?
So it's...
I don't think it's just insecurity. I think that there's a lot of like confident like women that I respect and look up to. And it's like, you think I'm an asshole. You pointed out why. And I don't even disagree with you, but you're still coming back. Like, why is it that women can break up with a man 17 times and still end up in the same spot?
Well,
men don't do that. I don't think so.
I don't know.
Well,
there's crazy women.
Yeah, there's men who do that. They keep doing it. I mean, listen, here's the thing. If
you're up to four, right?
Four what?
Breakups? With her, with your girl,
four or five. Right. She packed up everything this time. This was the most serious.
I mean, this
one.
Is still four, right? Now I know it's still a long way to.
She
17.
Made me delete the videos too. Like she made me like go through my phone and delete all the good stuff.
Oh wow,
that was a serious breakup.
Yeah, well here's.
But my point is this: four. I don't think I've ever broken up with a girl four times. Right? Or maybe it's been a long time since. I don't know why I'm asking you. My point is like, yeah, 17 is high. But guys do repeat the cycle. That doesn't mean you're going to keep repeating the cycle. But my point is, guys do that. It's not uncommon for a guy. Well, we know people who've done it four or five times.
Sure. How about this? Even if the girl broke up with you and you accepted the breakup, you're no better for accepting the comeback. Do you know what I mean? Like your girl broke up with you four times.
I would say threatened it a couple times. And I was like, all right. Fine, if you want to.
Yeah, but even somebody threatening that. So, like, I had shout out to my boy Cinnabon. Like, he went on. I tell this all the time. He went to the couples therapy to save his marriage, and his wife said, "I want a divorce." And he called me up and he said, "What do I do?" And I said,
"Divorce.
You give it a divorce." Yeah. And so 2 days later, they were sitting at dinner and the doorbell rang and the papers were served. She got the papers. She was like, "What is this?" I did that. And he goes, "You said you wanted a divorce.
Stick to your word.
You got a divorce." And so take her because she's not going to be a woman of her word unless you
follow up on it. Yeah.
You got to hold that.
But I've held her up to every time I've held her to that standard. Like I've been ready to, I went back to editing. I put the headphones on. I was ready to.
Yes, but if you're still giving her access to you,
so I'm just still, a dad. I'm just. I'm not.
Yeah. But I mean, don't get me.
You're learning
though.
You're learning.
Yeah, you're young. You're 22, and you're. I mean, I'm.
So I should have broken up with this girl.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not. I mean, you should have broke up with her, and at least. You know,
well, hold on. In all fairness, there are some things that you admit that you are not keeping your word on, like the.
I was a piece of shit. Like the piece of shit thing was like an accurate description of me.
Right,
like,
which
I think
is
that was
fair. And again, I like that you are more critical of yourself than anybody else. Like I was a piece of garbage, legitimately.
No,
all me. 1,000%.
This guy with thumbs.
This guy who's got two thumbs is a complete jerk.
This guy,
which I respect because you're being honest.
Yeah, you're being honest.
So that part of it plays into
but
it.
But you don't
too.
Understand. That's the thing that makes you attractive to women. Is the honesty on that? Even
I don't get, but I've openly lied to her so many times too.
Yeah.
Like, so I'm honest, but I'm also this liar who's been caught many times.
Yeah. So,
does
all right,
this depend
in all fairness,
on what you lie
he is,
on?
He is right. The foundation has been bad in this relationship.
Yeah, really
on
bad,
your end
really
as well,
bad.
Significantly.
Yeah, it's all been a mess.
So you can try to definitely salvage it. But if now you try to set it straight, so what you have to do from every time you. Break up or whatever. Now you have to go, what are the renegotiation terms of this that we're getting back together? So it either has to be, I'm going to be a faithful man, or you go, I'm going to be polyamorous and you got to accept that.
And she did.
She did.
The argument, like I said, she's like, okay, she didn't want to at first, but like she caved in.
Gotcha.
I held my ground.
Now here's the part of that. Now when it happens and it becomes evident to her, she's going to try you again.
I don't think so. Because I told her, like, she kept, like, assuming that you were with somebody last night. And I told her, like, all right, after a while, I'm like, I admitted to the lie. I was with some girl last night. I told her what happened. And she laughed. She didn't even, I don't think she felt a type of way about it.
Okay.
Are you thinking
Remember when you had that giggle in your head when she started running back?
Yeah.
Because I told you what was going to happen. All right. So,
and part of it is just the emotional aspect of it. If she genuinely likes you, then this is why I talk about not training somebody to be in that scenario, because the odds are it's not going to happen, especially with somebody younger. I'm assuming that she's also in her 20s.
Yeah.
Okay, so you can maybe deal with that with somebody who's a little bit older and experienced because they've gone through that and they understand what they've dealt with. But the situation is now she's going to, at some point, be very attached to you and she's never been in a polyamorous relationship or something. Right. So it's going to affect her. And so it's going to, she's going to try you because she's bothered by this. She's going to say inside
right,
something doesn't feel right.
I'm not saying it's wrong for her. I'm just telling you, she's got to, you got to, it has to be reiterated. It will have to be reiterated that this is what I'm going to do. And if you, this is what it's going to be. So I also, I'm not going to do this with you. And then you're angry because I'm doing it. If you're angry, then I'm not even going to give you access to me at all. Mm-hmm. Because, not because I'm being mean, but because I'm going, I just, you, this is clearly, maybe you don't have the ability to say no, and but this is not good for you because you're not going to be, you're not, you can't, mentally you can't get it in your head to the point where you can move on and not feel this way.
So it's going to come, how do you think it's going to come up again? Because she said she accepted it. She says she accepted the polyamorous
thing.
Yeah,
well, that's fine. So you got a verbal confirmation, but what happens now is when it happens and it becomes evident that you are, she's going to, she'll give you attitude. Maybe she won't. She'll come in with a funky attitude and whatever, and you got to go, yeah, I'm not, if you don't want to be here, just don't be here.
Don't be here, right. Yeah.
But understand you're not going to be here and make me miserable.
I mean, it could be, a literal form might be, like, hey, I don't got time for that. Oh, you got time for your other bitches.
Time for these other, yeah.
Oh,
I heard that word for real.
Like, oh, the Yankees play. Oh, did you take that bitch to the Yankees?
Yeah. I mean, it could, depending on, it's going to come in all shapes and sizes.
It
you
could.
Know what
it
I mean?
Depends on her with her personality, but she's just not going to eat it and not. But then you just got to reiterate and go, look, if you don't want to do this, then we could just not do this. We could just don't. We don't have to. You don't have to cry. You don't have to. Especially since y'all have gone back and forth a few times, you lose a little credibility. Every time you go back, you lose it. So in order to gain the credibility.
But I do understand that he had to reset this because he started out with a bad foundation on his part.
Absolutely.
And, but now that it's crystal clear in the open,
yeah.
Whoever violates the terms after that, there should be no
there's a contract.
Disillusionment as to what's going on.
There's a contract. And you get to say, but you could also say, listen, as much as you want this to be the case, it also, you get, this is what I call the benevolent king. The benevolent king is the king that's in charge of the kingdom, right? But he decides what's best for the kingdom, which doesn't mean his arrogant own understanding. It's not just, the king never worries just about the king. He has to worry about the whole kingdom.
He should.
And so if she's part of your kingdom and she emotionally can't compartmentalize this and say, okay, this is what he wants to do and I respect him and I love him for what he is and I want to be with him no matter what, whatever I can get from him, which I'm not saying that's right, wrong, or otherwise, but if she's saying that, she has to be able to have the constitution to do that. If she doesn't have the constitution, sometimes you have to go, you can't do this. You have to be able to say, you want somebody who's monogamous and who's going to do these things.
And I'm not that.
And I'm not that. And I'm not going to keep on this facade because I'm not going to be, and you're not going to be happy. You have to go find somebody who is that. Mm-hmm. Now, she, 9 times out of 10, they go, a guy who has that kind of self-awareness, she's never going to find that anyway. So she'll find some guy who's monogamous, but just don't have the swag that you got. And then she tortures this motherfucker because he's not you.
Yeah, she had that. That happened at one point. Like she said, I met this guy and I think I'm going to get cuffed to him. Like I'm going to be monogamous with him. And like I knew that was like a manipulation tactic.
Yeah, yeah.
That was attack mode. She says that it never was. I knew what it was.
Yeah.
And then she went around like
hung out with him.
Yeah, did some. But she said that he was like bored.
Cool.
Like he was boring.
Yeah, it's cool.
He was like a she said she could see her whole life with him. Like he'd be the loyal husband.
This is and
but
then
see,
I still
here's the
that.
Thing. The second she found another option that she thought was viable, she exercised that option, right?
So and she cut it off after.
And every woman will, if they find somebody better than you, they will leave with
nobody
that person.
Nobody stays.
And they should.
That's what he said. Nobody stays with you out of loyalty. They stay with you because you're the best option.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever that means. Maybe she doesn't feel as though she wants to go out and look again. Maybe whatever. But you are the best option. That's why they stay with you.
Man School 202.
Better hear what I've got to say because you won't get it again.
I'm not an alpha male. I'm not a beta male either. I'm just a better man.
Better man.
Put your happiness first, because if you don't, they won't.